to our QCT quarter four for dual language K through second. Also in the chat, you will find our participant guide and Miss Mari Salazar. It's going to be our second grade dual language specialist. And we have also here Miss Maribel Cruz as our dual language ESL specialist for kindergarten. Also, we got Miss Mercedes Hidalgo as our dual language ESL coordinator. So she works with pre-K through sixth grade. So if you have any questions, also notice on your participant guide, we have a parking lot. Since we only have an hour, we are going to try to limit this presentation just to that hour, and we are going to be proactive about it. So if you have questions or comments, please go ahead and put them on the parking lot. We will be very prompt, and we will be answering your questions as soon as possible, okay? So let's begin with our norms. And like Dr. Medina says, being fabulous, you're fabulous in two languages, so you can just be fabulous in English and Spanish. So we have our norms. I'm going to give you a couple seconds to read our norms, and please make sure your microphones are in silence. If you could please have your camera on. Like I said, we're gonna be vamos a hacer buen uso del tiempo, vamos a respetar las ideas de los demás y participar activamente. Okay. All right. So we got learning objectives for today. So we're gonna be learning about the curricular documents and resources available for quarter four. And first of all, we're gonna let navigate the resources for quarter four to support your instruction. And we're going to be able to identify resources that is that are gonna help you improve with MAP results as well. Okay. So in our agenda, we're going to be accessing Curriculum Central and review dates for assessments. We're going to look at the quarter four highlights. We're going to be looking at Amplify Supplemental Authentic Text Collection, very important for this last unit that is coming for quarter four. We're going to be looking to Amplify Visuals, Weekly Formative Assessments, or WFAs. We're going to be looking at MAP data and TEKS correlation. And last but not least, we're going to be looking at iReady. Okay, let's look at how we can navigate resources for quarter four to support your instruction. We all very familiar with Curriculum Central, and also on your participant guide. We're not going to go over again on how to find your curriculum, but we want to highlight the fact that we have office hours. Please go ahead and join us every Tuesday and Thursday from 3:30 to 5. If you have any questions, there's a link on the Curriculum Central next to your IPCs, next to the links to the IPCs. You just click in there. There's a Zoom meeting open. One of us, of our curriculum specialists, it's going to be available from 3:30 to 5. And I see that somebody's asking about the signing sheet. Don't worry about signing in, but in the end, we have to fill out a survey. That survey is going to be, is going to count as your attendance form, okay? So office hours, one more time, 3:30 to 5 every Tuesday and Thursday. If you have questions about Amplify, we're going to be there. This is our quarter four assessment calendar. It is linked on our IPCs and also on the Curriculum Central. You're going to find how it correlates to your knowledge and to your skills and MAP testing data. So just make sure you take a quick look. You know, remember that calendars are up to change. They're subject to change based on days that we're going to be out or things happening in our campuses. But this is going to give you a very good idea of how to schedule your lessons, okay, and testing. Okay, so we got some news about Amplify unit assessments in All In Learning. There is a new feature being implemented for the remainder of the year on activating the unit assessments. Now, these unit assessments will automatically change from preview to everyone access when the testing window opens. The issue that we used to have is that they were available at the beginning and some people wanted to change or edit some assessments. So this is going to be happening a week before or during the week of assessment when the window opens. Now, This currently is currently being implemented to all of our future K through second dual language unit assessments and all in learning for the remainder of the school year. Okay. Now let's look at our quarter four knowledge and skills highlights. Okay, so very quickly, where you can see when you look at the IPCs and when you look at the links, first thing that you like, just think about it as an umbrella. We can see the year at a glance. You can see what you guys are going to be covering for the rest of the year. Now you have the IPCs where you can find your daily instructional activities. Those IPCs are going to be including amplified visuals and weekly formative assessments, and we're going to be talking about them today. In our clarity documents, they are inside of your IPCs. We're going to be bridging the knowledge, and you're going to find some engagement strategies as well. Okay, so I'm going to do something real quick in here because we're going to take 15 minutes to go through different breakout rooms. Kinder, please stay in the main room. You will be with Miss Maribel Cruz. And first grade, you're going to be with me. And second grade, you're going to be with Miss Mari Salazar. So please, as soon as you see a little window popping up on your screen, you will go ahead and click in there, and we're going to have 15 minutes to discuss our highlights.
Yeah, Kinder stays with me. Good afternoon. I'm Maribel Cruz. I'm the curriculum writer for Kinder, and we're gonna talk about what Kinder will be doing on this quarter. So let's start on slide 17, if you're following the presentation. For habilidades y destrezas, Kinder will finish unit 7. They will continue working with consonant blends with the letter L. They will continue using common words, but this time they will be writing phrases using prepositions and will write a short text with the teacher. For Unit 8, the students will review some letter sound correspondences. They will use other common words. And in this unit, they will be writing dictated sentences using verbs and will write sentences using pronouns. They will plan a draft. They will edit that draft of a personal narrative and will revise it and publish. And then on Unit 9, since it's the last unit, they will continue reviewing some letter sound correlations. They will work on those sounds, on those letters that look alike or those sounds that sound alike, those letter sounds that sound alike. And they will also plan a draft, but this time will be an informative text. We'll write it, edit it, revise it, and publish it. For conocimientos, Kinder will be learning about the earth, about the presidents and symbols of the United States, and about art. They will learn the characteristics of informative text, and they will use technology to research information and will use technology to write a short text with teacher assistance. Another thing that is new for this quarter is that Kinder would actually be working on a research that's like the last writing project of or writing task of the school year. That will be on Conocimiento 12. They will be researching about different artists and their artwork, and they will actually write about that. On the previous unit, they will be writing, but not as detailed as they will do on the last unit of the school year. So another thing that I wanted to talk about is that for this last unit, for unit 12, you're not gonna have all the texts in Amplify. They're not digital. They're not necessarily available. So the district bought those for you. So in your school, you should have a list of I mean, you should have a box of those texts available for you. So you'll see, throughout the lessons, which ones are available and which lessons already have, the text in Amplify. And if it's not there, you will have to make sure that you have the text in the classroom. We put a picture here of the box so you know what to look for if you don't already have it or you need to request it from the person in charge of the books at your school. It has this red label that you can see on it, and on top it says Unit Authentic Text Collection. It only brings five texts, even though this list over here that is actually on Amplify. You can look for it under Materiales Suplementarios on Amplify on their website. It has an additional text, but that one is not available in the box. And it's not in the lessons. They mention it as one of the required tests for the unit, but it's actually not included within the lessons. So you won't need it. Another thing that I wanted to share with, the kinder teachers is the Dual Language 2.0. We wanted to make sure that you know that those resources are there. We're very aware of the time constraints that Amplify brings into your classroom, but remember that this year students are no longer learning English, in math, not even in math. So they're only exposed to English, in their specials. So that's why it's very important that at some point they get that exposure. So the Bilingüito centers are there for you. They're actually linked on the IPCs. They've been there all year. I'm just pointing out as a reminder here at in this purple box below the IPC for Conocimientos. And the links will take you straight to those web pages where you can, have access to the Translanguaging Center that has different activities. If you don't have time to print, the activities, they're already in Seesaw. So on the ideal world, students will do both. But if you don't have time and you don't have the resources, they're there in Seesaw for you. So all you have to do is, teach your students how to access Seesaw. And the good thing about these activities is that the vocabulary is the same vocabulary that they've been learning in Spanish in Amplify. So they learn about a word in Spanish that Amplify suggests, and then they're just learning to say that word in English. The other component of the Dual Language 2.0 are the English language development portion of your daily instruction. The expectation is not that you spend 20 minutes or half hour on this. It's good 5, 10 to 10 minutes. You already have the Velázquez Biliteracy program materials. You may still continue to use those. But the reason that I'm showing you this table is because I do take some time to get some videos that are related to the topics in Amplify that the students are studying in Spanish. So if you have, if you can take 5 or 10 minutes, you can show them a video of the same topic in English. Not necessarily the Amplify video. You can show that one if you want to. But I put other videos that I find that seem to be shorter, and they actually cover the same topics, and they use the same vocabulary. So this resource is also here for you. And the last one that is part of the 2.0, the Dual Language 2.0, are the competencias socioculturales. As we explained, these are meant to be used before your social studies block, so you don't have to teach this separately or anything. I do my best to try to connect those competencias to whatever they're learning in social studies. So this helps you, like, as a starter for your lesson. The recommendation is that you do them on Monday, but if you're not able any day of the week, I think we'll be okay, because I try to cover whatever they're doing in those weeks. Where do you find those? Like I said, they're also here on the bottom of the IPCs for Conocimientos, but they're also on the IPCs, on the social studies IPCs. If you go to those IPCs, to plan your lessons, you're going to see that they're there. There's also a link there on the bottom, as you can see here on the screen. The other thing that we wanted to remind you are the bridge. That these are, like I said, another opportunity for our kindergartners to be exposed to the English language. So for social studies and the other subjects that we've done in the past quarters, they're included in those IPCs. This is actually the IPC for social studies for week one on quarter four, and this little box right here has the bridge for for that unit. You don't do a bridge every day, remember? You do them at the end of the unit. I put the whole deck for the different units on the same slide deck. That way, if you couldn't do it, in the previous week or something, you still have those slides there for you to, get ideas on the vocabulary that you should be discussing with your students. So, if you have any questions on what's upcoming for this quarter, I'm here. Any comments? I have this survey that I would truly appreciate if you can fill out. It's actually on slide 38. It's showing up on the screen as a bit.ly. We do love the feedback of teachers. We want to make sure that we work for you. So we want to make sure that our work is useful, that we try to provide you what you need. So please feel free to complete it, and provide us your feedback. So if you can take a couple of minutes and get to that bit.ly right here on the screen, I'll truly appreciate that. And if you have any questions, you can also let me know. Does everybody see the bit.ly on the screen?
Yes, I see it.
Done.
Was everybody able to complete the feedback? I have, I think, 9 people.
Yes, ma'am.
And
thank you so much.
If you are in first or second grade and you would like to go to the breakout rooms where those sessions are happening, just look at the bottom of your screen. You're going to see a square that is subdivided by 4 little squares. If you press on that, it says breakout room, then you can go to the other room.
Oh, here.
But today we're going to focus, we're going to use the rock and roll vocabulary strategy and the vocabulary.
I'm sorry, another item that I forgot to mention that we also include in the IPCs are the conexiones bilingües. We're still including those on this quarter for all the grade levels. So please, if you have, the time, this is another opportunity for the students to be exposed to the English language, our kindergarteners. Amplify has, sometimes they're very, very simple. Nothing is very complicated. It's actually like embedded in your lesson. So I just wanted you to remind that we do put the page number on the IPCs. That way, when you're planning, if there's a particular conexión bilingüe that you're, really, really want to make sure that the students don't miss, the page numbers are there for you to identify, which conexiones you have on every week.
Maribel Cruz is going to continue with the presentation.
Yes, I would want to talk a little bit about the Amplify visuals. These are actually the slide decks that Amplify makes for you. They're not, we don't make them. We make some edits to them, but they're there. They've been there for the past half, I believe so, of quarter number 3. So they'll continue to be there on quarter 4, but we wanted to let you know that we will make them available as soon as we get them. Since we don't have control of, when Amplify have them ready for us. As soon as we get them, we try our best to put the links on those IPCs. You can always email us and let us know, oh, I don't see any Amplify visuals. But just make sure that you know that if you don't see one, it will be because most probably we do not have it yet. Those visuals are available for both habilidades y destrezas and for conocimiento. We're still providing our... We're still providing our language support slides, and those, you know, you can use to also along with the Amplify slides to prepare, you know, your instruction. The next thing that we wanted to talk about, this is a sample Amplify visual. If any of you haven't seen one, they're available for all three grade levels, kinder, first and second. This is the format that Amplify uses. That's the type of font that they use in all the visuals. They look very similar, both conocimiento and habilidades. If you have access to the, to the presentation, you can click on it and it will take you to that Amplify visual for that specific lesson, which is for second grade. Another resource that we wanted to let you know was the Amplify Alive. This is actually a spreadsheet, is a document that makes connections with science and social studies. Since most of the texts in Amplify are actually about science or social studies, there are some team members that have worked really hard to put some videos that have more information on those topics that you are already teaching to your students on Amplify. You can have access to this document through a link that we provided on the participant guide. And as you can see, it goes, if you look, for example, for kinder, it actually goes by units, the different topics that students are learning. And the phrases in blue are those links that I'm talking about. Just more information about the topics that students are already learning in Amplify. Another thing that is new, but not so new, because we have been including these for the past weeks on quarter three. These are the weekly formative assessments. We were instructed to make two of these for you in All In Learning. So every week you're gonna have access in All In Learning to two exit tickets that you can use in your classrooms. Okay, these are about the lessons that you're actually teaching in Amplify. We make them. We try to use the vocab part section of Amplify. Sometimes for kinder, we use some of the questions for about verificar la comprensión I do those. So please, if you have any feedback or comments, feel free to let us know. The link to those formative assessments, you can find it on the IPCs. If you see the red arrow on the screen, right there, right below the Amplify visuals is where you're gonna see the link for the weekly formative assessment, okay? And like I said, they're only two per week. They're not daily. So you're gonna find them in different, under different lessons. Those weeks that you're actually assessing your students for evaluación intermedia, evaluación final, you're only gonna have one WFA, one weekly formative assessment, since you already have another assessment for the unit for that week. Another way to, on this image, you can see how when you click on that link, you're gonna get in All In Learning this tab that says activate assessment, Amplify Spanish. In this case, it was, a first grade example. So you can click on preview and you'll see it right there. Another way that you can access the assessment is if you go straight to All In Learning, you go under your account, make sure that you choose, you know, your assessments. And when you go to conocimientos in every unit, you're gonna see the little box that says exit tickets. That's how they are named. Exit tickets, and they're gonna be right next to the assessment if it happens to be that, you know, that there's an assessment. So for this example here on the picture, There's like two exit tickets or WFAs for week Unidad 7 from quarter 3, and then 9 for Unidad 8 from quarter 3, and only one for Unidad 9 of quarter 3. So we haven't included those yet, because when we make them, we have to wait for Amplify to make them digitally. We submit them as a Word document. They have to put them in their platform, and then we have to revise them, and then we put the links. So it takes a little bit, but you'll see it, you know, by the time you come back from spring break, they should be there, the ones for that week after spring break. And like I said, please feel free to give us any comments or feedback on those assessments.
Hola y bienvenido a escuchar los que son los highlights de primer grado. Vamos a ver lo que se va a ver en este quarter número 4, el primer grado. Para las unidades de habilidades y destrezas, vamos a continuar con lo que es la lección, la unidad número 7. Continuamos con las últimas 9 lecciones. Ya habíamos comenzado con 7 lecciones de esta unidad. Y vamos a terminar en el quarter 4. Vamos a continuar con lo que son los sufijos, el sonido de las letras, las palabras compuestas. Vamos a leer y escribir palabras con el sonido de la letra J en G, G. Escribir palabras con J y con X, identificar sufijos de ito, ita, los diminutivos, formar sustantivos en plural y palabras compuestas con sufijos or, ora, ito e ita. Vamos a leer y escribir palabras con K y el sonido de la S, identificar y expresar palabras comunes como después, estaba, pues, porque, tenía y hacia, hacía. En la unidad número 8 vamos a trabajar con lo que son los prefijos, los diptongos, los adjetivos, la aliteración. Es mucho que ver con lo que es el sonido. Leer y escribir palabras con el prefijo des, decir y escribir oraciones declarativas, reconocer y usar pronombres posesivos, escribir palabras multisilábicas, usar pronombres personales de tú y usted, saber diferenciar entre ellos. Formar oraciones declarativas en tiempo pasado, ordenar palabras alfabéticamente, decodificar y escribir al y del en frases preposicionales, identificar y expresar palabras comunes como mayor, alrededor, desde, contra, además, posible y ambos. Y ya vamos a terminar entonces con lo que es la unidad 9, con el código básico, sufijos or, ora, las rimas, oraciones que riman y la mezcla de consonantes. Vamos a identificar adverbios de tiempo, reconocer acentos, escribir oraciones con al o del, leer y escribir adverbios y contracciones, leer y escribir palabras con el sonido k, formar oraciones completas con concordancia entre el sujeto y el verbo, identificar y expresar palabras comunes, tales como frente, era, igual, más y menor, y repasar las diferentes ortografías para el sonido k, sonido con la letra k, 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 ko, ku, okay, o palabras como ke, ki. Ya en conocimientos, vamos a terminar, vamos a comenzar las primeras 3 lecciones de la unidad 9, y vamos a terminarla, esta unidad, Una Nueva Nación, y la unidad número 10. Quiero recalcar el hecho de que estas 2 unidades son de texto informativo, son bastante concentradas en lo que es la historia de los Estados Unidos y lo que es geografía. Una sugerencia que les puedo hacer es que utilicen mapas. Los estudiantes van a estar buscando y trabajando con lo que es la geografía y localizar estados, localizar asentamientos, localizar lo que es el norte, sur, este, oeste. So es una, son 2 unidades muy fuertes en lo que es los estudios sociales, así que les recomiendo que puedan utilizar un mapa grande en el salón para ubicar. Es algo muy interactivo, algo que les gusta mucho a los estudiantes, la unidad 9 y la unidad 10. Vamos a trabajar en la unidad 9 con demostrar comprensión del vocabulario clave, establecer un propósito para escuchar, profundizar la comprensión lectora mediante la estrategia de alguien quería, pero así que entonces esta tabla para hacer comprensión lectora se encuentra en los libros de actividades de los estudiantes y muy fácilmente pueden crear una tabla para el grupo en general llevar a los estudiantes entonces a que puedan utilizar su pensamiento crítico, explorar la escritura informativa, recopilar y sintetizar información y luego registrarla en un párrafo informativo, completar la evaluación del conocimiento, identificar la información importante y hacer una secuencia de los eventos en un texto. Cabe resaltar aquí que uno de los estándares más comunes que van a encontrar aquí es el 1.9D2, que se trata sobre utilizar gráficas y trabajar para buscar información en un texto informativo. Es algo muy fuerte en esta unidad. La unidad 10, Exploradores de la Frontera. Trabajamos mucho con lo que son aquí los personajes importantes de la historia de los Estados Unidos, como Lewis and Clark, Sacagawea, la compra de Luisiana, unos personajes que son muy importantes y es algo muy interesante para los estudiantes. Aquí vamos a otra vez a demostrar comprensión del vocabulario clave, establecer un propósito para escuchar, profundizar la comprensión lectora. Vamos a completar la evaluación de conocimiento. Esta es la última unidad en la que se va a hacer una evaluación formal. Ya les hablo sobre la unidad 11 más adelante, pero esta unidad, la unidad número 10, es la última donde van a encontrar una evaluación formal. Vamos a identificar la información importante y hacer una secuencia de los eventos de un texto y explorar la escritura informativa, recopilar y sintetizar información y luego registrarla en un párrafo informativo. Esto nos va a ayudar, nos va a llevar a lo que es la unidad número 11, donde vamos a estar trabajando con cuentos de aventuras, en donde vamos a estar trabajando cuentos relacionados a personajes reales, como Gabriel García Márquez, Gabriela Mistral. Vamos a estar trabajando con estas historias, pero es una mezcla entre la fantasía y la realidad. Vamos a trabajar con mucho con lo que es el uso del diagrama de Venn para usar comparaciones y contraste de información de cuentos. Los estudiantes al final van a estar trabajando mucho con lo que es la escritura informativa y recopilar y sintetizar información para luego registrarlo en un párrafo informativo. Y al final van a completar una actividad en la que los estudiantes van a estar presentando tal vez a una cierta medida básica lo que es una presentación de una investigación al recopilar datos. Muy importante, les quiero dejar saber que la unidad número 11, los cuentos que se van a estar trabajando en la unidad número 11 no están localizados dentro de la plataforma de Amplify. Vuelvo y repito, los cuentos que se van a trabajar en la unidad número 11 no están localizados dentro de la plataforma de Amplify. Lo que quiere decir es que van a tener unos textos suplementarios. Estos textos, usted puede encontrar la lista de estos textos aquí cuando usted entra a la plataforma de Amplify, usted puede encontrar la lista. Vamos a estar trabajando con Me Llamo Gabito, la historia de Gabriel García Márquez, galapagueña. Vamos a estar trabajando con Me Llamo Gabriela, El viaje de Calac, Señorita Mariposa, Charuco, el arqueólogo peruano, y Abuelita fue al mercado. Estos textos usted los va a encontrar en una caja que se va a encontrar dentro de su campus. Si usted de casualidad no encuentra esta caja, por favor hágalo saber inmediatamente a la persona que está encargada de comprar textos o adquirir los textos para su campus. Muchas veces esta persona tiende a ser lo que es el assistant principal, pero usted por favor encárguese de buscar eso con antelación porque estos son los libros que va a necesitar. No es un set para la clase, es solamente un libro por grupo. Así que no va a tener una colección de estos libros. Estos libros están identificados por un sticker, un label de este color, va a ser a color amarillo. Y fíjese, por favor, que en la caja diga Amplify Supplemental Unit Authentic Text Collection, grado 1 SP de español. Algo que noté en el día de ayer fue que una caja que donde, en donde venían esos libros también decía Amplify Caminos Research Unit. No está marcada como igual que esta, pero exactamente todos los libros vienen en esa caja. Puede que tenga alguna de estas dos en su escuela. Por favor, asegúrese desde ahora que estamos en el, a principios del cuarto número 4, que tenga esta caja porque la va a necesitar para su última unidad. Fíjese que el, lo que es el ISBN es exactamente el mismo para las dos. Así que la, los libros van a ser iguales. ¿Cómo es la caja? La caja es una caja delgada, no es muy grande en tamaño. Son unos libros pequeños que usted va a encontrar. Es una caja delgada. Por favor, asegúrese que la tiene en su escuela. Estos son los libros que usted va a encontrar dentro de esa caja. Por favor, verifique que tenga sus libros en la escuela y si no, infórmelo inmediatamente. ¿Okay? Vamos a hablar ahorita lo que son los recursos de lenguaje dual. Esto es un recordatorio nada más que en sus IPCs ustedes van a encontrar en la parte de abajo lo que se llaman las colecciones bilingües. Estas colecciones bilingües están, son, es un refuerzo para hacer conexiones crosslingüísticas a través del lenguaje entre inglés y español. No todas las unidades van a tener conexiones bilingües. En las unidades en donde se encuentran estas conexiones, nos encargamos de poner la página donde la puede encontrar. Es como, hágase, es una mini lección entre inglés y español y una conexión entre inglés y español para los estudiantes. Fíjese que, por ejemplo, esta que está aquí abajo es de primer grado. Existe una conexión bilingüe en el día martes, miércoles, jueves, viernes no estaba disponible. Así que no todos los días, pero es un recurso más que usted puede notar para utilizar con sus estudiantes. También no se olviden, por favor, que vamos a tener lo que son los puentes o actividades de puentes. Estos puentes están localizados, por lo menos para la sección de SLAR, se van a localizar en al final de cada unidad. En este caso, para el cuarto 4 van a tener tres puentes, uno al final de la unidad 7, otro al final de la, mentira, I'm sorry, uno al final 9, de la unidad 9, uno al final de la unidad 10 y el otro al final de la unidad 11. Y los estudios sociales se van a encontrar en el, al final de cada unidad de Studies Weekly. Los de ciencias se van a incluir al final de cada ciclo, de cada lección, que puede que sea tal vez una vez a la semana o cada 2 semanas. Y matemáticas los va a encontrar al final de los módulos de Eureka. Puede ser 1 o 2 veces por quarter, dependiendo el largo de este módulo. Estos puentes estamos trabajando, ahora mismo estamos trabajando con subirlos a sus IPCs. Pronto ya van a estar 100% disponibles. Lo último que con lo que los quiero dejar es con, si pueden por favor entrar a esta dirección que encuentran aquí para poder hacer cualquier tipo de comentario. O es una encuesta sobre lo que les gusta, lo que no les gusta, lo que han tenido alguna situación con el, en cuanto al currículo. Por favor, déjenoslo saber. Y aquí entonces vamos a tomar en consideración su opinión para entonces poder mejorar esto para ustedes. Espero que esta parte les haya ayudado y que si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, no duden en contactar a Vanessa Vázquez, yo soy escritora de currículo de primer grado y por favor me deja saber y aquí estaremos muy a la orden para ustedes. Muchísimas gracias, que les vaya bien.
Okay, so we're going to talk about second grade highlights. We have about 14 minutes, 15 minutes, so it should be plenty of time and even time to allow to do a short survey at the end of this part. We still have another section, just so that you're not doing surveys all at the end of the hour, okay? So here we have conocimiento, the knowledge. We're doing unidades 10, 11, 12 in English and Spanish. I will let you have a few seconds or a 30 seconds maybe to look at that, but I want you to pay attention to unit 12, unidad 12. you'll notice that, and you'll see it in the main room, that it's a supplement. They have a lot of supplemental books, a lot of supplemental materials, and the English and Spanish books don't match. So you'll just be teaching those as standalone lessons, you know, every day. There is not a unit assessment for Unidad 12, for Unit 12. So you don't have to worry about, oh, this is not going in order. We have this story in English and this story in Spanish, because it's not, it's a different kind of unit if you've not taught second grade before. And we're going to go delve into that a little bit more when we get into the main room, okay? So there's your lessons at a glance for, or just your topics at a glance, sorry, for conocimiento. And just a reminder, we're not testing in Unit 12, okay? And then your habilidades and destrezas. Our main unit that we're doing is Unidad 6 in Español, en habilidades y destrezas. You do a little bit of Unidad 7. It's like 3 or 4 lessons at the end. So obviously you're not testing in Unidad 7. You are testing in Unidad 6 in habilidades y destrezas, okay? So you will have a unit test on that. You will not have a unit test on Unidad 7, because you can see we barely touch on that the last few weeks of school. And if you noticed, I don't know if you've already looked at your IPCs for the quarter four, you might have something to notice if you haven't. The last 6 days, well, the last 2 or 3 lessons are optional. And then the last 3 days have a pausing point. So all in all, you have 6 days at the end of the year as like your flex days, because it'll have lessons on there, but it'll stay optional. And then also throughout the weeks, not just on the last 2 weeks, you'll also have pausing points and stuff like that throughout all the weeks. So it's just not going to be at the end, okay? But I wanted you to notice that if something comes up, I know sometimes you can't really have a lot of wiggle room with the time frame, since the assessments open up at a certain time. But you have just something to keep in mind. You have a lot of pausing points, definitely, to allow for any flexibility as needed, okay? And then in skills, in the English part, we'll be looking more at Unit 5. You do start a little bit Unit 6 in English, but again, it's not even, it's maybe a few days. I don't think it was even several days, and they may have been optional. But we do have an assessment test for Unit 5 in skills. So that's why I mainly put the ones that you will have a test on, Unit 5 in English, skills, and then Unit 6 in habilidades, Unit 6 and habilidades y destreza. Okay. So just some points to notice. And then moving on. So again, we have, and these, they probably were not, these, this one was just ready, updated on Monday. And so if you haven't seen it, it is linked now on the IPC. So this is linked under quarter support. And this one is basically like another pacing calendar, but it lets you see a little bit more in detail what you're doing. And again, the links that you'll see like right here, those are the links to the language support that can be found on the IPC in the clarity section. So that part hasn't changed. We are getting a lot more amplified visuals. I believe I have everything updated up to week 5, and I am trying to get that as ready for you, because I know they are very useful. So you are updated up to week 5 and plan to be a little bit more updated by the end of this week for sure. Okay. And one thing, when I was talking about Unidad 12, o Conocimiento 12, Unit 12, Domain 12 knowledge, you'll have the books there. It's a different kind of unit, like I mentioned. The students don't have the little readers that you're used to. You will have these books. So if you look onto your left, these are the Spanish books on the left. So when you have your lessons, these are the ones you'll be using. And then in English, they're on the right. Now, I'll go back to these pictures in just a minute, but you should all have a set on your campus somewhere. And the boxes look like this. So if it's a Spanish, you'll have the label SP. And then the English will just say grade 2. And it's the authentic text collection. So please check, if you don't have that, check with whoever's in charge of your books, which is usually like the AP or what other, any other book coordinator. Sometimes it's a teacher or the reading teacher or CILT member. I'm not sure. It varies everywhere. Mm-hmm. So please ask about this. And you should have one. If you're the Spanish person, the SLR person, you should have it in Spanish for sure. If you're teaching the ELR portion, you should have it in English. There are several teachers that are doing it all, so you should have both boxes, okay? And again, I don't want you to feel too stressed out about that. This is a very interesting and enjoyable unit. And so it's a little bit more lax in the sense that you don't have to worry too much about a test at the end, but it is definitely an enjoyable unit for the students. They really enjoy this one. So let me go back to this to show you the books. In your Spanish box, there is only six. I don't know if I was missing any, but there's only six here that we saw in our Spanish box. And then our English, it was about seven.
I'm looking at Miss Taylor's case.
In English, even it was in English, there were seven books. So just want to make sure that you have that and ask around for it if you don't see it. Okay. And then let me see. We still have a little bit more about our dual language resources. Just a reminder, I hope that you can all hear me okay. It is getting a little crazy in here. We are still doing our conexiones bilingües, and they could usually be found only in the Spanish section of your habilidades y destreza in kinder, first grade, and in second. So they're still available this quarter four for you. And again, our Amplify visuals are ready. We're trying to get them. Second grade has a lot ready up to fifth grade, but I did hear kinder and first are still missing some lessons, some weeks. We still have another batch, they call them batch, that are still coming to us. And then, Gloria, I think I still have enough time, so I'm going to go ahead. Gloria, you can come off mute and ask your question. Ms. Prieto, I think somebody had a question.
Yes, I just want to know if these books are going to be read aloud or every student is going to get one.
There is not one for every student. We were discussing that just amongst us. It's a read aloud, just like the regular read aloud. Yes. Mm-hmm. And then you may have a different one, like if you want to project it or something. We do have a little bit of images available, but not because it's a trade book. There's copyright issues, but you can project it to your class. Some, if you want to, yes, you can do that. Okay, and then I know for sure, I know this is second grade. I know Kinder First found some digital formats. So I'm checking to see if there's any digital ones available. So if there are, we'll definitely link them in. And that'll be the last unit in unit 12. Okay, thank you for that question. It's a good question. Okay, and again, this is your conexión bilingüe. Usually just has the connection or to show you what it looks like in Spanish and in English. Especially like this one, we're doing the verbal is. It's an irregular verb in English and Spanish. So it's really good to see these together side by side after you presented the Spanish lesson. So you could see so the students could see what it is in English. And this is very helpful for the students. It helps to make that fast connection to the opposite language, okay? And then here we still have, these are still a work in process as well. We have bridges, not just in our reading, but also they're coming up in social studies, in math, and in science. So I think you saw some of that in quarter three. So if you haven't checked those out for quarter three, be sure to check your social studies and your math and your science for any of those bridges. You should have those available, okay? And I'm running a little blurry on the information about science. That may be on the English portion, but I believe they were also in the dual language part as well, okay? So we still have those bridging activities, the social studies. And again, just a reminder, you may not see those every week in social studies. The bridge will be available at the end of the unit or the end of that teaching section, okay? So here you see math, the bridge is included at the end of each Eureka module, which could be once or twice per quarter, depending on the length of the module. And science, I think, was pretty good about having one every week just to make that connection with vocabulary, okay? All right, so we still have, I think we have about 3 minutes left exactly. I want you to go ahead. I'm gonna put this bit.ly, I'm gonna do this. I'm going to put this in the chat so that you can take the survey now.
Now, Mari is going to talk a bit more about resources that can help you improve your math results.
Maribel, can you go back a little bit to the one you were just on right now to talk? Because second grade is a little bit different with the WFA. So just to touch base on this for second grade, you're going to have two of them. Sorry, I know second grade is a different thing. English and Spanish, one each. The day we have an assessment and conocimiento or knowledge, you will not have any WFAs, okay? And we're only having them in knowledge. So just that information is a little bit different for second. If you still need more information, you can always email me. You have our emails in the presentation, but also in the parking lot, definitely put that question. You can write down now, what is it that second grade does with WFA? And then I'll answer you, okay? All right, Maribel, I'm ready for the next one. Okay, we have the next success criteria. I can identify resources to help improve MAP results. Okay, so what we're going to use for this one, the resource we're going to use is Amplify. And then Vanessa is going to talk about how you can also use iReady to help you find some resources to improve MAP. Give me just a second. Okay, sorry. So then you might have already taken your MAP data and you have your results, and you can see like all the bars that are colored are the percent or the students that took that skill and the average of that skill, right? And we notice that if obviously if something is in red, that means that they need more help in. And we don't usually have the TEEQ or the standard written out so beautifully. I think some of your schools do are able to put that, find the TEEQ for that. But if not, you'll be able to tell by the skill, right? You can see phonological awareness, rhyming. Those are usually your decoding and spelling, your beginning TEEQ for kinder first and second. And then you'll see your sentence and word work again, decoding, your A's and your B's and your TEEQs, right? But we noticed, for example, like we can see that first grade had needed a little bit of extra help in certain topics, for example, locating informational text. And I think they also had needed a little bit more extra work with spelling patterns and phonological awareness. At most grade levels, the littles, we always have to keep working on that, right? And one way you can help find something in Amplify, which I think we've already been kind of doing, is finding where that TEEQ is presented or that skill, if it's not, I know MAP, I think some do convert into the TEEQ, but you can tell the standard, you can help locate that TEEQ in your Amplify correlation guide. And if you see on the next slide, you'll see right there, each TEEQ, each guide has it for each grade level. You see kindergarten, first grade, and second grade. At the end of each guide, teacher's guide, you'll see this TEEQ correlation. I think a lot of you may have already found this, but this kind of, it's kind of like an index, if you will, if you think about it. The TEEQs that you need to work on, for example, first grade needed extra help with TEEQ 1.9D2. And then if you look over here, you can look for that TEEQ, right? I don't think it's on this screenshot, but you can definitely find that in your TEEQ correlation guide. Again, they're in every conocimiento book. They're in every habilidades y destrezas. So if you want to find another quick way to find it is look in your IPCs. Look on your IPCs. You see for quarter one, week one, this is first grade, quarter four, sorry, quarter four, week one, first grade, you see where 1.92 comes out, and it's rasgos y gráficas simples para localizar o obtener información. So here you see this, it comes out on Monday, Tuesday, not on your FALSA, and then I believe that's Thursday, got a little bit zoomed out, it's Thursday, right? Vanessa's nodding yes, so it's Thursday. So there you can see where that TEEQ that your students, that first graders need to improve on, you can see where that's going to be at, right? And then another way we could see on the next slide is now you can look on your, when you're doing, especially like when you're working on your internalization piece, now you could see where those specific TEEQs are located in the lesson throughout the Amplify lesson so that now you could focus on that. I know we hear a lot, and I know you, I mean, we've been into classrooms and it's just amazing how I see y'all able to do all of it because it's, You just do magical work. But we all run out of time. We're all pressed for time. But when you know exactly where the teaks are that you need to focus on, you can focus on that segment of the lesson. It is important to do the whole segment, right? But when we're being realistic and you're running out of time and say, well, let me do this little piece. Maybe today I'm not going to be able to do all of the application, but I do see, let me see what the 1.92 is in here that I need. Let me see what part is covering that, right? And then if you see on the next slide, you actually see right there in those questions on the application part, those questions are the ones that are directly related to 1.92. So yes, it is important to answer all those questions, but if again, if you're pressed for time in the real world and you know your students need help on 1.92, I'll be like, okay, I'm going to focus on these because I know this is a skill that my first graders need extra practice on. So this is what I'm going to do because I have like 4 minutes left and not the usual 15 that I thought I had, right? So that's just real world and how you would use that to help you in a real world situation, okay? And then now I believe if you do, like there is, we do have a link here where you can do asynchronous courses for MAP training. It'll give you more ideas if you haven't had more training or maybe talk to your reading team, reading coach, ILC. These courses online are asynchronous and it can help you. And the links on your presentation, it can help you learn a little bit more like, okay, what do I need to do about grouping? How could I find out this? Where is it? What is the Amplify that's exactly like? How can I be sure and use my MAP reports and maybe get different kind of reports so that you can help correlate it even better with Amplifier to kind of really hone in on what you need for quarter four. So definitely, it's definitely worthwhile to take a look at what courses you think you would need. They're asynchronous. Do it at your own pace. Do it while you're eating, not while you're driving, but you can do it while you're eating for sure. Okay, I think that's all I have. Vanessa's going to talk about another resource to help improve our math results.
All right, so you may notice that under your IPCs, you'll see where it says intervention. We have actually linked an iReady intervention guide, or basically a guide for you to get more resources to work with those areas that our students are low on them or wherever they need more help. So we have linked, this is exactly how it looks. It has your skills unit and your knowledge unit. So if you go to iReady, it's going to be located on your Clever. You can access through iReady on your Clever and you can find where the lessons are or where you can go to get more resources for that, for those areas. Okay, so and it tells you how the estimated lesson time. So they're actually very short activities. So you can just take them for like those 15 minutes, 12 minutes, 10 minutes, and you just modify them as you need them, okay? So they're all linked on your IPCs. And when you go to iReady, it's pretty friendly user, but I would love you to later on just play with it and start learning how to locate these resources. So mostly when you click on the Assess and Teach tab, you'll see Tools for Instructions for Spanish Reading, and you'll see them located on the very top. You got reading Tools for Instruction for Math and Reading, but the Spanish Reading ones is where you're going to find activities. Let me see what goes next. Okay, this is basically how it's gonna give you. It's gonna give you. You can look it up by It does not filter through by TEAK. But for example, if I am looking for informative text, so I can actually start typing text informativo, and you can start looking at activities that will lead you to by skills. You can look at them by skills. So you can, it's going to give you your prep time. It's going to give you what materials do you need. And you can create a mini lesson with it. Okay.